Now we shall learn how to send a view model to a view. This is something that you're going to do a lot, because view model allows you to send a lot of data. Let us see how the concept works. From what we have done in the previous, we are getting a list in a variable, and then finally we are setting it into a view. The limitation is that this concept, you should understand it very carefully, because I have seen people take some time to understand this one. This is one limitation. The limitation is that you can only send one object into view. Now, if this is a list of, let us say, TBL Airlines, and I want to send current date equal to now, I also want to send current date to the view. Now, I can't pass this as a separate object. I can't pass this as a separate object, because only one argument is possible in a view where data can be passed. You can't write like this: view LST, comma, current date. This is simply not allowed. There has to be a workaround. The workaround is through view model concept, which allows you to virtually pass unlimited amount of data to the view. Unlimited amount of data to the view. The trick is this: create a class, let me call it my view model. Any name, it is not compulsory that it should be ending in view model or it should be my view model. You can give any name to this class. I'm writing class my view model, and here I'll set a property public list angle bracket whatever, and here I'll write flights followed by the getSet story. Then I can add another property public date, current date or whatever. Add even more properties, add even more class objects, collections. You can add as many properties down here. Therefore, you can send as much data as you can. View model is the way. And then you create an object of my view model inside your action, set all these properties and pass that object to the view. So in that way, you'll be able to pass all this data into one object, flatten into one object, and send that object to the view. And then access that object with the capital model. Since all these properties are public, we can write model.flights. It will give me access to all the flights. So this is the basic concept that we'll work here, and let us see the implementation. This is the project we were doing the last time. We queried TBL Airlines, passed them to the view, and inside the view we showed them in a for each loop. This is what we did in the